And now we will learn about recording checks and expenses and what the difference is between these two. You will find that recording checks type of transaction or expense type of transactions are almost really the same thing. A check transaction is when you pay immediately and when you physically give a check. This reduces the bank account and it increases the expense or asset that you paid for. With a check, you have to record a check number because you physically gave a check. Now, an expense transaction really has the same result and is really almost the same thing. When you pay immediately. Now, in both cases, you record either a check or an expense if you pay for something and you get it at the minute that you pay. That's completely different than the way we were doing in earlier videos where we first got the bill on one day and then paid it on another. This is different from that. This is when you get the when you receive the service or you receive the asset, you pay immediately. The expense transaction also reduces the bank account. It also increases whatever expense or whatever asset you're paying for. But instead of recording a check number, you put in the reference field the transaction number. And you usually record an expense transaction for paying online, or you record an expense type of transaction if you're paying from a cash on hand fund or a petty cash fund, which we're going to address in the next video. For example, let's imagine on February 3rd, we pay check number 3 for $500 to Staples for supplies. Supplies will increase by $500 and become $1,180. And cash in bank will decrease to $21,270 because it will go down by the $500 that we just paid in this check. The vendor's balance will not change at all. And the reason the vendor's balance will not change is because if you pay immediately, the vendor doesn't, you don't owe the vendor a different amount because you paid at the moment you took the service. That's the difference between the two transactions you're learning about here and the previous vendor transactions you learned about in the previous videos. So let's go ahead and record check number 3 on February 3rd for $500 to Staples. Let's reduce this here. Let's click the plus sign, go to the vendor section, and click check. Okay, now the date was February 3rd. The vendor that you paid, Staples. Okay. Now, you do have unpaid bills with Staples, but we are not going to be paying one of these previous bills. What happens on February 3rd has nothing to do with these previous bills. It's for supplies we're paying for today. Now, what we're paying for is supplies. So we click supplies, and the amount we're paying is $500. So now we have everything we need. Check number 3, paid from Cash and Chase Bank, paying to Staples for supplies, $500. That's it. This situation assumes we physically wrote check number 3 and sent it in the mail at the moment we click Save and New or Save and Close. Good. Now when we come back to the trial balance, reports, my custom reports, my trial balance, you can see cash in bank is what we predicted, $21,270. Supplies are supposed to be $1,180. Let's see. Supplies, $1,180. So we recorded it properly, and the results are as exactly as what we expect. Now let's do an example of an expense. Let's imagine on February 4, we paid Rex Repair for a job that we received today, February 4. So we paid Rex $1,000 for coming over in an emergency and repairing something for us. And what happened on February 4 has nothing to do with the previous bills. Let's imagine we paid online and we got confirmation number 87654, because every transaction needs some reference number. The repair expense is going to increase by $1,000. So after we record this expense, repair expense should become $5,050. Cash in bank should decrease by $1,000 because we just transferred $1,000 into Rex's bank account for this repair. So the cash in bank should become $20,270. And remember, the vendor's balance does not change. We paid immediately for something we immediately received. And this online transfer has nothing to do with the previous bills. So let's go ahead and record it. Click the plus sign in the top right, and under vendors, the first choice is expense. Now you notice it looks almost exactly like the check field. The only difference is this says reference number instead of check number, 87654. The vendor is Rex Repair. Notice even though that we have these bills, we're not paying these bills. This is a separate charge for an emergency visit. Now, the payment date we said was back on February 4th. And of course, the account is repair expense, and the amount is $1,000. Now, it's not yet associated with any particular customer, so this is enough information to record the expense. When we click save, after QuickBooks confirms that it's saved, we can go back to our good friend the trial balance and take a look. Cash in bank, $20,270. Well, that's what we predicted. Cash in bank, $20,270. Is repair expense $5,050? Repair expense, $5,050. So that's exactly how to record an expense, and that's exactly what the results will be. And again, vendors' balances don't change because you're not paying a previous bill.